Hi students, I am Pavan, your science master. Today I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about third chapter, animal fiber, and various sub-concepts related to animal fiber also we have been talking about. Students, especially till the last class, we have completed story of wool and getting woolen yarn. In the process of getting woolen yarn, there are different levels, there are different steps. Can you recollect the steps that I taught about getting woolen yarn? What are the steps involved in getting woolen yarn? Let me write the steps in a flowchart format. Okay, first of all, sharing, next, scouring, next, sorting, next, dyeing, combing or carding. I'm giving upward arrow so that you know that looks, you know, that is in continuous process. Next, here I forgot to give you one thing, that after sorting there you need to do another step, that is bleaching. Here bleaching, why bleaching is done? To make it disinfect. Okay, combing process, after combing process rolling, and at the same time, along with rolling, there is another process followed, that is twisting. Here in the rolling process, what is rolled here? Fiber is rolled. So here 3 to 8 fibers are taken separate and twisted by the twisting process, and then finally what we will get? Twisting is nothing but what? Spinning. After spinning, in the spinning process, what do we get? Yarn. After we get yarn, the another process we follow is weaving process. So after weaving, what will be ready now? Fabric will be ready after weaving. How to do weaving process, that we have spoken in the last class, last videos. Especially I made a video based on weaving process, you know. So weaving can be done by manual or automatic. So in the manual process, there will be human being involvement, okay, but in automatic, power is used. So the fabrics that are made by manual, that fabric is called hand looms. and the fabric that which are made by power looms. Are you clear, students? Here, so here, as far as the weaving is concerned, in the process of making woolen fabric, the process followed by manual is knitting. How knitting is done? Here in the knitting process, there will be two needles. Okay, in the knitting process there will be two needles. In this knitting process, they make knots. In the knitting process, they make what? Knots. By loops and rings. Loops and rings make a knot by using two needles. Okay, students, how knitting is done? You can search videos in YouTube. You will find so many videos to understand knitting process. Okay, so knitting process is done by manual. In the weaving process, weaving of what? Woolen fabric. So it's done manually by knitting. Students, in the knitting process, there they make knots using two needles by loops and rings. Got it? So woolen fabrics are also made by machines, same like how silk fabric and cotton fabric are made. You know weaving process? Same like they take longitudinal arrangement of the yarns, they insert horizontal yarns above and below to the longitudinal yarns which are fixed. Like that, they make a fabric. The process is followed by machines, and that is power loom of woolen fabric. Okay, is this clear, students? Once again, let me give you the information. First, shearing. Shearing is nothing but trimming, scouring. It's nothing but washing, and after it is washed, then sorting. You have to separate the quality wool and the broken wool. And after sorting process, bleaching is done to disinfect the wool. If any disease causing microorganisms present, then they are killed by bleaching process, sterilization process. Okay, next, dyeing. It gives attracting colors to the fiber. Combing is done by a long tooth combs. Combing may be done by machines or manually, and this combing is also called carding. Especially these terms are used in making yarns. Okay, next, rolling process is done by machines. Along with rolling, twisting is done, then spinning makes yarns, and then the spun yarn is used for weaving fabric. So that may be done by manual or automatical. Then the manually or automatically, you can understand that the next process. Here, you have to collect information about the differences between project work collect information about the differences between a woolen or silk and cotton. Okay, collect information about differences between woolen or silk and cotton. Here let me give you a table. If you are collecting information about differences between silk and cotton, silk or wool, take any one. If you want to take silk, write only information about silk. If you want to take wool, you have to write information only about wool here. Okay, because these two are animal fibers. Okay, we get because these two we get from animals. Okay, right? And cotton we get from what? Plant fiber. Cotton fiber we get from plants. So the main differences that you have to write here, and at least not less than 5 points you have to cover here, then you will get project work marks. Okay, like that. So I hope you understood what I have taught in this video, students. Please follow me, please watch the videos till the end, and if you have any doubts, you can give me in the comment section, which is right below the description box. Okay, and also I'll give you some videos links related to the chapter in the description box, which is right below the title of this video. Okay. Okay, students, this is for this video. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.